Hello, everybody. How's everyone doing? Thanks for joining me. I'm Jen, and I'm just doing a little marbling this afternoon, almost evening. I am creating some orders and just thought I would jump on and share the process. So, hello from Bali. Oh, I'm so glad you stopped. Thanks for saying hi. I'll try to catch some of your comments as I'm painting, but it's hard to read and paint at the same time. So I'll do my best here. This is Ebru. It's an ancient Turkish art form of painting on water. And I do a whole lot of creating silk scarves. That's what I'm doing right now in this big long tray. And this is an order for what I call the holiday table runner. So good afternoon from Florida. Oh good, I'm so glad you caught me. Hello, Aurora. So just getting a few orders done today and thought I'd share. So it just dropped in to say you are, oh, that's so nice. Oh, that's so kind of you. Thank you. Trying to see some of your comments. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. This is the holiday table runner that I'm doing in a bouquet style. So this is actually more like neutral earthy colors. Normally when I jump on and do lives, I have my husband on here with me. So yes, I am on early tonight, and this is not one of my normal days either. So we usually do either Monday or Thursday. And but I was just creating some orders and thought I would share the process. So normally my husband and I go live on Mondays or Thursdays. At 7 Central. So that's a good time to catch us because he's reading the comments for me while I'm painting and we have a lot of fun. So I'm trying to kind of get used to jumping on by myself. It's definitely a lot different jumping on here without him. So you've watched many times. Oh, never been disappointed. Thank you. That's very sweet of you. It's kind of, Oh, you got a notification? That's good. Oh, hello from Indonesia. I'm in Boise, Idaho, and it's been a little cold here this week in the 30s, and I have my studio set up in my garage, so I kind of wait to marble in the afternoons when it gets a little bit warmer. Got a couple of heaters going on out here, and so it's working. Thank you, Mrs. B. Thanks for being here. So this is water marbling. It's floating acrylic paints on a tray of thickened water, and the water is thickened with carrageenan. It's a seaweed extract, so it's a natural product that's actually found in some foods, so it's not harmful. Oh, hi, Captain Cat. Yes, I am much earlier than normal because hubby's not on here with me. So I'm just doing, getting some orders done and thought I would just share. Otherwise, I'm just kind of out here by myself anyways, so. I'm always happy to answer questions the best I can. Yams and marshmallows, that's funny. It does, doesn't it? Okay, I think I'm done with my colors here. So gonna do a little raking with this one. This is just a piece of wood with nails. Any of these steps I could stop at and it could be any one of these designs, but I'm gonna keep going for this one because this is an order that somebody placed, but this one I call the Long Hearts design. Try not to drag it along the bottom and make a funny noise. This one is the long zigzag. And then I use the really big rake and go the other direction. So this one is the length of my tray. And there are 3-inch nails in there. So this design, the viewer is named Scallops. See that one there. This one I don't stop at as much as a lot of the others. This one is sideways zigzag. The traditional term is called galgit. And now I'll use the comb. Oh, sideways zigzag is your favorite? Yeah, I like that one too. It's very uniform. Oh, you like the peacock, Mackenzie? I'm going for the peacock design. I call it peacock or, it does have a fall look to it, doesn't it? So this is the comb or nonpareil design. And then I'm going to be doing the peacock or bouquet design. You want to go kind of slow because if you go too fast, it moves the paints too much. And then this is the double rake. So the nails are alternating. So where am I located? I'm in Boise, Idaho. It did look like feathers, doesn't it? I'm in Boise. I don't currently teach in person, but I do have a course that I created that walks you through every step. You can message me if you have any questions on that, or you could find it in my bio. But I do also do Zoom trainings. And then I also just share all kinds of videos. But I like to help people get started because there is a lot to getting started with this process. Just getting your paints to float properly and the water the right thickness and all of it. It's kind of like a science experiment, the way it all works together. So this is the peacock or bouquet design. And I'm gonna put this on a heavier silk that a lot of people will use for table runner. So I'm just gonna get that set up really quick. So give me 1 second here. I've got some PVC pipe that I use to lay the scarf down by myself. So this is the, it's a heavier silk that I'm gonna hook to my little contraption here to be able to lay it down. So it just takes a second here to get it all set up. Okay. This part's a little more nerve-wracking because it's got to go down just right in order to not mess it up. So it has happened. If it does, I just end up double marbling it. But getting it lined up perfectly is a little tricky. Because you can't stop as you're laying it down or else it'll mess up the design. So, that worked. So I've just got little clips at the corners. So again, this is on a heavier silk, a table runner. Just creating an order for somebody. Hello, hello. Oh, you did, Captain Cat. That's awesome. I love that. I don't remember which one you ordered. Oh, where is hubby? He is working. That's why I'm kind of on at a weird time, because I'm just here creating orders. He has been putting in some really long hours. Oh, thank you. Let's see, Mama's belly. Thank you so much. Yes, I can create hearts. So anyways, he's been working some really long, hard hours the past few weeks, and we're hoping that it's all gonna calm down this next week and that we could be back on at our usual time. So we've missed just our, you know, being on here doing our normal thing. I've had a lot of people asking me where we are and what's been going on. So he's been tied up with a big project at work and has been working late. So I'm hoping we'll be able to be back on together on Monday. So just putting a little paper towel in my clips so that they don't get the next scarf wet. So this one is the holiday table runner. And it's the bouquet or peacock design. Oh, how much are they? And can I make it with roses? Yes, I do roses, and they're 65. So whether it's the heavier silk or the lighter silk, they're both 65. And I do all kinds of flowers. Actually, the next one I'm gonna make is gonna have flowers on it, cherry blossom looking flowers. So I'm just giving this a quick rinse in some filtered water. It just gets the excess sizing and paint off. But once this had touched the water, it was instantly set. So I'll try to show you this best I can. Usually I have another set of hands helping me. So there we go. So this is the holiday table runner. It can also be done on the lightweight scarf too. Hello, Allison. Thank you, Mackenzie. Let's see. You got the daring crossbody. Oh, good. I'm so glad. That's awesome. I love hearing that. Thanks for all the nice comments. So I'm just gonna let this soak for a little bit. I like to put it in a little fabric softener just to make it extra soft and smell good. And then I'll hang it to air dry and iron it, and it'll be good to go. They're 100% silk. Oh, thank you, Allison. I'd love to see blues like that. Oh yes, I can do different shades of blues and the bouquet design. I've done blues and white. That's really pretty. So I just have to get the excess paint off of the surface. If you ever have questions and I don't catch your question here, you can always message me. Happy to answer questions. Let's see. Are they for the table or to cover your body? Well, mostly the lightweight silk people wear scarves, and then the heavyweight silk is a table runner. But they can also be worn as a scarf too. They're about 14 by 72 inches, just to give you an idea. So after I'm done cleaning off the surface, any excess paint that you see will not get on the next one. So this next one I'm gonna do is the cherry blossom scarf. This one takes me a little bit longer because there's a lot of detailed flowers on it. So I'm just gonna do one more here for good measure. Hello, Leah, thank you. 19 millimeter? No, the heavy silk is 10 millimeter. The lightweight silk is 8 millimeter. Do you do custom orders? Like if someone wanted specific colors? Yes, I do. I do that all the time. So if you go on my website under shop scarves or shop table runners, you'll see a listing for custom, and there you can choose your colors and design. And it's also $65 for custom. Let's see, there is still paint in there. Yes. No, I can't make them wider. I can only do as big as my tray here. And the paint that you see is actually underneath the water because I cleaned the surface up. But because I work with heavy body paints, some tend to drop to the bottom. But it will not affect the next one as long as the surface is clean. Let's see, won't the brown show on the new one? No, it won't, because it's all underneath the surface. I know, it's kind of crazy. You would totally think it would. So right now I'm creating the background. What kind of paint do I use? I use heavy body acrylics and mostly Utrecht. How did I get into this medium? Actually, it was kind of crazy. My dad saw this art form being done on the East Coast and he thought it was so cool and said, you gotta go check this out. And I started Googling and found a woman that was teaching it in Chicago. I lived in the Chicago suburbs. And just started taking classes and just took an interest in it and practiced for several years. And eventually that led to creating a business out of it. So I started off on paper doing florals specifically for a few years before I switched over to silk and started giving the experience for others to create themselves. And then when COVID hit, I went more online and more teaching online, sharing through a course and lives and that sort of thing. So, how deep is the water and do you have to change it every day? Yes, custom is 65. Thanks for sharing that. The water is, gosh, maybe half an inch right now. I'll do anywhere. Let's see, what is my favorite type of blue? I use phthalo blue. Your mom loves her scarf. Oh, good. I'm so glad. I love hearing that. I feel like there was another question in there. The water is just about a half inch deep. I think I forgot what the other question was. I'll try to catch it if you say it again. But I'm just creating the background right now for a floral. Oh, hello, Jennifer. I'm glad you caught me. My mind is so concerned about the brown. You're a mess. I promise you there won't be any brown on it. Oh, that was the other question. Okay. Oh, and how often do I change the water? That was the other one. I can keep using this water over and over again as long as it doesn't get too muddied up and the surface keeps coming out clean. And so I can do up to about 20 scarves or so. But it just really depends because as I'm using it, it's going down and so I have less and less. So yeah, some of the old color just naturally sinks underneath. Oh, Jennifer, you got two puppies. Oh, how sweet. I want to see pictures. That's awesome. Yeah, no, it does kind of get pushed to the side, but I have to make sure all of that is off. So I'm starting off with a clean slate every single time. Hello from Indonesia and Malaysia. Awesome. I'm glad you guys are here. Okay, I'm going to keep going here. I could just keep reading comments. I need to keep going with my painting here. So with florals, it's a little tricky to get the right amount of paint on the background. Because what I'm doing is, you just got another kitten this week. Oh, that's so fun. Don't you just love that? The scarves I ordered came in the other day. Oh, good. I'm doing good. Let's see, if I DM you, would it be possible to get a customized ornament, just red, green, and gold? That I can see, yeah, message me and I can see if I can do that. Hello, Jamaica. I'm gonna keep moving here because it takes me a little while to do these cherry blossoms. So I'm just adding a little green here because they stayed a little smaller and I want to make them bigger. So I'm just adding to it. But these are going to be the leaves and then I'll be adding the flowers. And obviously it doesn't have to be exact on here because I'm just going to kind of blend the dots together. Can you buy this one I'm making now? Actually, this is a cherry blossom scarf that I offer. So I was making this one for a customer, but I do this design often. So they're each one of a kind, but I make this design quite regularly. So, oh, you sent a million pictures. Oh, good. I'm excited. So yes, you can order the cherry blossom scarf, so you'll be able to see what it looks like here. If you just go on my website under shop scarves and scroll down a bit, I think it's kind of farther down, but you'll see the cherry blossom. Let's see, what kind of paint do I use? How do I make it stay on top of the water? I use heavy body acrylics, mostly Utrecht and some golden. And the paints have been thinned down and they are floating on top of thickened water. So it's the combination of the thick water and the thinned paints that help them float. I tend to talk slow and choppy when I'm painting, so would I be able to make the swirls into foxes in a custom design? No, with this art form, you can't do that kind of detail, like images like that. The only real images I can do are hearts, swirls, leaves, and flowers. Those are the only real images. So I've kind of pulled off like clouds and a few different things like that, but specific images really are not possible. The only time I've ever seen it is if somebody was working on a very small tray and keeping it super detailed. So how do I thicken the water? The water is thickened with a powder seaweed extract called carrageenan. So you can actually find it in some different foods. So it's a safe product. Oh, thank you, Pixie. Thank you very much. Keep moving here with my flowers. I actually want to make my paint here open up a little bit more, so I'm going to add a little surfactant to it. Which is actually the surfactant that I'm using right now is Dawn liquid dish soap. Cherry blossoms are your favorite? Yeah, that's one of my favorites too. Cherry blossom behind you? Well, it's very similar to that. I do it a little bit differently than that. Actually, this one right here is more of what I'm going for. I don't know if you can see, this is a little bandana one. So this is what we're going for. few drops on top of each other to help them grow. And I'll be blending the scattered ones in together. So with this whole process, I'm starting with a blank surface and gradually filling it up. So if you saw me create the background, those first couple of paints were really opening up wide because they just have plenty of room to open up. And I made the surface pretty full. So now, and that's why I do a background, because then it helps keep these paints more condensed for the florals. So it's a little tricky, and depending on how much paint you have on the background, then that determines how much the paints are going to open up. So sometimes I'll do less paint on the background, and then I can make real giant florals. So I just have two more colors that I'm going to add on top of these. So you can see over time they're gradually growing. So a lot of people will ask, how quickly do I need to work? You don't want to let the paint sit on too long, because it will just keep changing and it will actually start to crackle. So the longest that I have ever really worked is about 45 minutes, but they definitely start changing at that point. So you definitely want to be like, keep moving efficiently. What is this? This is water marbling. I'm painting on water. It's also called Ebru. When is hubby joining? I am hoping on Monday that he will be back. He's been working some long hours. Let's see, I'm going to add a little surfactant to this one too. So it's just been a like unusually crazy time for us. So those that haven't been here before, we normally go on Mondays and Thursdays at 7 Central. My husband jumps on here with me and he's reading comments, and we have a lot of fun. What do I use it for? These are silk scarves. Can you do linen or cotton instead of silk? Yes, you can. And I mostly do silk. That's just kind of the direction I've decided to go. But yes, you can do different types of fabrics. And these are starting to do a little crackling, which it's okay if it starts to do that some, because it does actually give a really cool effect. I'm just kind of wanting a touch of the hot pink in there, because cherry blossoms don't have a lot of the hot pink. I think I'm going to add a little bit more surfactant in here though. The trick is to not add too much, because then the paints will go crazy. So water is what makes the paints flow, and then the surfactant is what helps open them up on the water. So yes, the surfactant I'm using is Dawn Concentrated. Scarves that are already done are hanging in the back. And I do have a ton of different ones on my website too. The crazy thing about this art form too is all the paints like have their own personality and act a little different. Some crackle sooner than others. Some are just more powerful and open up more than others, and some just stay more condensed. So it is a matter of really getting to know your paints and how they work. Each one is prepped individually, so they don't all take like the same amount of surfactant or water. You just gotta test and retest, and it's quite a process. It's a science experiment getting it all to work together. I know it looks a little crazy right now, but it'll all come together in the end. A lot of the florals take me longer because they're so detailed. So just one more color here and then I'll be done adding the color, and then I can design the flowers. Thanks for sharing the live. Okay, now I'm just gonna add a little light pink. They look like cookies, yeah. How would I remove if I'm unhappy with it? I would put a paper towel on top. Just lay it on top and it'll pull the paint right off the surface. And then, I mean, it's rare that I'm not too happy with how one turns out, but if one gets messed up or I really don't like it, I'll re-treat it in alum, hang it to dry again, and then double marble it. And those are some of my favorites, because when you double marble, it gives a super cool 3D effect. You a little peek into my creating process. What kind of paint do I use? Thanks for answering questions. I use artist quality acrylics, mostly Utrecht. So creating the flowers is a little more tedious. But this is where it all comes together. So thank you, Jennifer. Thanks for answering. I'm gonna be tied up for a few minutes here, so I appreciate you answering questions for me. Probably out of the screen right now. I'll be coming in. Here we go. Let's see, why do I have to treat the scarves? The scarf would not soak up the paints. It actually is very light if you don't pre-treat it. So pre-treating it in alum, it's a fixant or mordant. And that's what helps the paint soak into the scarf as soon as it's laid on the water, and then it's instantly set. And the same goes for paper. If you're marbling on paper, you need to pre-treat in alum. The leather I don't need to pre-treat. I've tried it and it actually acts as a barrier. So leather, I don't do anything to it. I just use a natural leather. And then the ceramic ornaments that I do, I don't have to pre-treat either. Try to go a little quicker here. One of these days, I'm gonna take the advice of raising my tray up. Oh, thank you so much, Brenda. Yeah, I need to someday raise my tray higher because these detailed flowers start to get to my back a little bit. Getting there. Able to read comments in a few minutes. Gotta kind of keep plowing through these flowers here. Time is of the essence. Because the paints are slowly changing as they're sitting on the water. This is kind of reminding me a couple of years ago, I had a poinsettia table runner that I kind of had go crazy. It went viral, and I just was making poinsettias over and over and over again. That was a little crazy. Okay, we are on the home stretch here. Thanks for those that have stuck this out and are being so patient. Miss any. My arm must be sore. Actually, it's more my back than my arm. All right, I think we're good to go. So it'll just take me 1 second here to hook up. This is the white silk scarf that I'm gonna be laying down. So I just gotta hook it up on my PVC piping here. Little trick to laying it down by myself because it has to be laid down on the water in one continuous motion, and if it's not, it will mess the design up. And I have had that happen to me numerous times, and then I'll end up double marbling if that happens, but hopefully we're good to go here because this took so long. So the trick is getting it lined up just right. Smooth all the way. Okay, is that pattern spoken for? Actually, this is one that I've done many times. This is the cherry blossom design. So if you're interested in this one, if you go on my website under shop scarves, you'll see, if you scroll down, you'll see the cherry blossom design. So there are a handful of designs. Oh, thank you, Sarah. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Tammy. You guys are so nice. Yeah, I actually, yes, my website is in my bio, blueivymarbling.com. I did see another marbler do the PVC pipe idea, and it's just been so good. Hello from Istanbul. Okay, just putting a little paper towel in the corners here to keep this dry. And then I'm gonna pull this off and show it to you. So this is the cherry blossom design. good majority of the scarves I make are just more individual designs, but I have a handful like this floral that I do often. Each one comes out one of a kind, but it comes out very similar looking. So I like to just get a little color on the edges just to blend the white edges in. Hello, Pittsburgh. So there's the cherry blossom. Oh, got a couple people in Pittsburgh. Awesome. Thank you, Hope. Thank you, thank you. Okay, I'm gonna give this a rinse. Thanks to those that have stuck this out. I know that took me a long time. So yeah, I had a lot of paint drop to the bottom on that one. This cherry blossom design, one of the viewers that has become a friend, she made a couple of suggestions to me, and one was trying cherry blossoms. Then this one has ended up being one of my most popular designs. And then also another floral, it's a purple wisteria. That one has been really popular too, and she had suggested that one. So, oh, thank you so much. Yes, rinse in plain water, that's right. It just has to be filtered. It can't have too many chemicals, especially like chlorine, because that can lighten it up. I'm gonna try to open this up and show you. So usually I have another set of hands here to help me do this, but I'll try to give you the idea. So I'll let this soak a little bit longer. I like to put it in a little fabric softener. How many times can I use the water? I can use it over and over again until it just goes down real low, or as I get it so colored and my paints start crackling, then I'll switch it out. But I just keep using it multiple times. And I can even use it for a few days in a row. Let's see. Thank you, Jennifer, for answering questions. I appreciate it so much. Forget-me-nots for dementia. I have done forget-me-nots. Yes. Yes, I do all kinds of florals. So I'm gonna take the paint off the top here, and I'm gonna do one more. So this next one that I'm gonna do is a custom order where the person chose the colors and design that they want. Hello from Indonesia. Let's see, that looks like a gorgeous background to start next. I wish I could. You know, it looks like there's more paint than what there actually is. I've had so many people ask me about the paint left over. All these pink, hot pink dots that you see, that's actually at the bottom of the tray, underneath the surface. So one time we laid a scarf on top of what was left over, and it came out super light. So there really is very little paint left over. Almost all of it transfers onto the scarf or whatever is being marbled. So I just have to make sure there's no paint on the surface. So you can see there's some on there right now. So I have to go over this a few times in order to get it all off so that it doesn't get onto the next stuff. Especially because I'm not using this teal on the next one. If you were using the same colors on the next one, you wouldn't have to get every single bit of it off. See, there's still a little bit in the corners there. Okay, one last time in the corner here, and then I'm good to go. So I know that hot pink is deceiving, but it won't get on anything. So because the water is so dense, the color drops to the bottom, yes. Yep, that's right. Oh, thank you, JB. Thanks for sharing that. Jennifer, you are so kind. Thank you for answering questions for me. Okay, this is a custom order where they ask for yellow, orange, black, light blue, and tan. I think I said them all. So very different. Not colors that I would normally choose, but that's what's so cool. That's what happens with custom orders and when we're doing lives. Just color combinations get chosen that I would never think to do, and kind of amazing how they end up turning out. What paint do I use? I use heavy body acrylics, mostly U-checked and golden. I'm sorry, I know I missed another question. Oh, thank you. You guys are so awesome helping answer. Thank you, thank you. Have I ever used air to push the color around? Yes, we have done that on a live a couple of times. I've used a straw, and yes, I'll be hanging it up. After I'm done on the live here, I'll hang it to air dry. This one's gonna end up looking a lot different than what you would think because of the color on the bottom. It's kind of throwing it off. So this person requested these colors in the bouquet design. So I'm just somewhat evenly distributing these. Did the cameraman moderator not show up for work? Yes, exactly. He's doing his other job. I could use his help. What are these used for? They're silk scarves, so people mostly wear them. But the heavier silk are used as a table runner. Some people just use them for decorating or hanging on a purse or a backpack. I do have some smaller bandana size ones that can be worn in your hair or tied on a bag, used as a belt, all kinds of things. Some people will frame them. Hello, hello. Oh, being a make-believe celebrity. Yep, we're missing him tonight. Yep. Your Beetlejuice themed one. Oh, you do? It's a bracelet. That's awesome. I would love to see that. I know Jennifer, my moderator here, she's tied hers all up in fancy ways in her hair. I'd love to see it as a bracelet. Going with colors that somebody chose. They're gifting it to someone. Hello, hello. Oh, we're getting all kinds of nice compliments here. I'm sorry I'm not catching all of your questions. Oh, thank you, Sharon. Okay, they also wanted a little tan in here. So again, this is a custom order where somebody chose the colors and the design they wanted. So whether it's already made or custom, they're all 65. Same with whether it's a scarf or table runner. Let's see, did I get all the colors? Orange, blue, black, yellow, and tan. So it's looking a little light to me. What do the scarves feel like when they're done? They end up being very soft, and yes, it is silk. I let them soak in a little fabric softener that helps them get extra soft again. And then I also run it through my hands to soften them up. So they're very soft when you receive it, and then as they're being used, it just gets softer and softer. Back to the original way they started. So I'm just adding a second layer of each color just to make it a little more vibrant. And you can see now this orange is not opening up like it was the first time because the surface is getting fuller, but it's brighter the second time around. So I'm almost done adding the colors here, and then I'm gonna do the designing. Two more. Very 60s mod. Yeah, I know. This is a wild color combo. It's going to be very bright. I'm always kind of curious why people choose the colors that they do. Sometimes I get the story behind it, and sometimes I don't. Like, I just posted a video of somebody that ordered a custom scarf for their mom, and they had sent me a picture of her artwork, and so that was the inspiration for creating the scarf. Feels like school colors, and maybe it is. Yeah, I don't know, it very well could be. That's the long hearts design. I like the tan in there. The tan up against the black. It's making me want to do a tan and black and white scarf. Okay, that's the long zigzag. Just gonna pop a couple of, sometimes the bubbles pop on their own, and then sometimes I need to get them. Okay, now we're going to do the big rake. That's the scallop design there. This is sideways zigzag. See, I would have never chosen this color combination, but I'm liking it. Let's see, repeat asking. Oh, I'm sorry, I missed that last question. Retro vibes. I know it does, doesn't it? Okay, so this is the comb. It's got 3-inch needles, so you have to be really careful with it. You have to go real slow through the water so it doesn't move it too much. So this is the comb, or the traditional term is nonpareil. So this is a very old ancient art form that dates back to around the 12 to 1300s, just to give you a little bit of background. Started off on paper and bookbinding. So this is a double rake. You liked it before, that design? Yeah, and the cool thing is I can stop any step of the way. Okay, so I'm gonna do the bouquet now. This one is called bouquet, or the traditional term is peacock. So everybody's tastes are so different. A lot of people just like the stone pattern where they're just, the paints are sprinkled on. Others like the swirl, a more loose design, very free flowing. And then several of the designs are more detailed and uniform like this. So something for everybody. Okay, I like the black in there too. All right, I just need to grab my scarf. Just take me a second here. Again, this was a custom order where the person chose the colors they wanted and the design, which is really cool because I've never done anything like this specific one before with these exact colors. And it'll be a one-of-a-kind gift. So I'm just getting my silk scarf hooked up on the PVC pipe here, so I can lay it down by myself. Okay. Ready to go here. Just gotta get it lined up just right. And try not to mess it up. This is the trickiest part of the whole thing, when I don't have another set of hands. All right, we did it. You would wear more silks if you knew how. Yeah, there are all kinds of different ways you can wear them, and there's a lot of videos out there now that show you different ways. Let's see, better print with natural fiber. I think silk comes out the best. It comes out the most vibrant. The other mixed ones, not quite so vibrant, but you can still get some really pretty designs. Thank you, Ritzy. They're acrylic, artist quality acrylics, not the cheap kind. Oh, thank you so much, Lauren. Thank you. Thank you for answering questions. Let's see, I'm just trying to get some paper towel in my little clips here. And I'm gonna get some paint on the edges, and then we'll pull it off. You guys are so nice answering questions for me. So those that are new here, My husband does lives with me quite often. We try to jump on either Monday or Thursday evenings at 7 Central, whichever works out for his work schedule. And we have a lot of fun playing music, and we have a fun question of the night. And he's reading off everybody's questions and comments, and we've got three moderators that are helping us out. So it's just, it's a fun time. So definitely, if you follow, then you'll hopefully get a notification when we jump on. Yeah, that turned out nice and vibrant. I think that's what they were hoping for. So very different kind of color combination. So yeah, that was fun. I could say I've never done this exact combination before. But I just love what people choose, you know, different things that I wouldn't normally do. And so it's fun. It definitely gets me out of what I would normally tend to do. Usually on our lives, we let the viewers have a chance at choosing the colors and design, and we do it like totally random. And sometimes those are my most favorite scarves. Totally stuff I would never choose. So I'm gonna try to show this do the best that I can, but I like what they chose. It's really different. Okay, here we go. I think you can get a good feel of for it there. So I'm just gonna let this soak a little bit, and let's see. Oh, how neat! Thank you. Yeah, they did. It does look kind of fallish, doesn't it? I'm gonna let it soak a little bit just so it'll soften up, and then I'll hang it to air dry and iron it. They are 100% silk. They can be hand washed and then hung to air dry. So a lot of people ask if they can be washed. Not in the washer or dryer, but oh yeah, are they washable? Yes, hand washable. I'll let it soak in it with a little bit of fabric softener. I just put a dab in there just to help make it extra soft. So please tell you're going to make another one. Hi, Stacy. No, actually, I think I've been on for over an hour. I've made three of them now. So I'm going to try to jump on again tomorrow. But I'm done for this evening, so... Your backache's watching me do this. I know mine was hurting earlier making those cherry blossoms, but doing better now. So, well, thank you, everybody. It's kind of different for me jumping on without my husband reading all the comments for me. So thank you, Sharon. Thank you, Captain Cat. You're still here all this time. You're so sweet. All right. Thank you, everybody. Thanks for joining me. I'll jump on again tomorrow as I'm creating my orders. Thanks, JB. You have a great evening, too. Thanks for being here. All right. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you soon.